Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So are you wondering about how good Madoka Kaname is? Is she worth all the crystal for her summon? Is she worth the blood of your wallet? Is it worth raising her with all of the limited resources and time? In this video, I will explain and showcase how good Madoka Kaname is. So make sure that you guys watch it until the end of this video. First of all, for some reason, she is one of those units that got the highest rating on the Japan server, which I assume is the same for the global version. Madoka Kaname is an excellent offensive and defensive attacker that is easy to handle for beginners to advanced players. Yes, basically she is an awesome nuker. For molten element or shield, I say fire element. Well, just in case if you don't get used to that molten element thing. The skill tree deals massive damage with AoE attack and defense penetration. In addition, if the enemy performs a skill action while the skill tree can be activated, the cooldown is zero, your critical damage can get boosted by 8% and defense will increase by 3% up to 12 times. Yep, we can stack those buffs up to 12 times. So in total, you can get the maximum amount of critical damage, 96% buff, and the defense, 36% buff, which is insane. Madoka's speed is slightly faster than average, so even if she attacked by an enemy while waiting for a turn, she may only get minor injury if she has a defense boost. In addition, two debuffs are removed at the start of your turn, so it is easy to get a clean hit even if the hit rate or attack power is reduced by the enemies. Skill 2 attack all enemies and has a chance to attack all enemies again, slightly lower power. With skill level up, it will be activated twice with a high probability for up to 70%. Also, since this is an additional attack instead of an additional turn, it can be activated even if Homura Akemi and others disable the additional turn in PvP. The first skill attacks a single target with normal attack and gives attack plus 50% buff for one turn. Furthermore, if it's in a buff state, it advances the action gauge. Yeah, basically it will boost the character's move so that the character can do the next action faster, basically. Rather than using the skill tree first, you can attack normally, wait for the opponent's skill to activate, and then activate the skill tree after stacking buffs. The damage could be insane. So here is the difference between using skill tree right from the beginning compared to if you use the first skill to get attack plus 50% buff before you use the skill tree. The unbuffed skill tree did 16.6k damage to the boss. Now let's try to buff her with the attack plus 50% from the normal attack first. Then wait for her skill 3 cooldown. Okay, now is the time. Skill 3, let's go! Boom! 27.k damage. Quite a huge difference, isn't it? So basically the attack flow for manual control is skill 1, 3, 1, 2, 1, 1. Then wait for the cooldown of skill 3. Then use skill 3, 1, 2, 1. One. Basically, use skill 1 to get the attack buff, then use skill 2 or skill 3. That way, you can get higher damage, basically. In order to maximize the firepower, it is necessary to upgrade the exclusive equipment, get the perfect max gear, max tech, max level, and rank up the unit. It may be difficult without paying, especially the rank up the unit, but try to strengthen it within the collaboration period as much as possible. You can get the materials to level up all of her skills and her exclusive weapon to the max from the Madoka Collapse event shop, so do not miss that one. You may not need much speed when waiting to activate skill 3, therefore 4 sets of attack or 4 sets of critical damage and 2 sets of critical hits can be the ideal gear set for Madoka. Yep, using the attack set gives her a lot more damage. And also, we need the critical hit rate for the consistent critical damage. For the recommended substats, try to get attack percent, and then critical rate percent, and critical damage percent in all of your gears if it's possible. Try to aim a decent critical rate, like at least 70%, with the follow-up of decent attack boost and decent critical damage. Since you can get some critical damage boost from the idol of skill 3, as mentioned before, around 200-250% critical damage is already decent in my opinion. But if you can get as close to 300% or more, altogether with decent critical rate and attack percent, it's even better. you need to try to get the combo of attack percent, critical rate, and critical damage boost, if it's possible. So the one that I equipped here are mostly have attack percent and critical percent, like this one. And this one. This one is decent, even though the attack is not attack percent, only normal attack, just attack, basically. It has critical and critical damage. The critical is decent with 10%, so okay, I love it. And this one is also decent. Attack percent, critical percent, and critical damage. I got all of those three in one gear, which is nice. And the fourth part is HP, so it's okay, I think. This one, I don't have any better one, so I'm just going to use this temporarily. I'm trying to get critical rate and critical damage if possible with decent attack percent like this. And this one, attack, critical, and attack percent. No critical damage, but okay, because I need the critical rate. And this one, attack, well, too bad it is not attack percent, but the attack is quite decent, 183, so I'll take that. Critical rate and critical damage. Yep, the set is attack set to get attack plus 35% boost, and critical set to get critical rate plus 12%. Which is nice. And as you can see here, the critical rate is 77.3%. If I can get critical rate from this part, let's say 10%, it will be 87% critical rate, which is my Madoka will always do critical, like most of the time. Which is great. Not having critical is kinda like having an attack reduction stuff. So yeah, to do critical all the time is really good. And my critical damage is 226.9%. I know, right? I still can increase this amount into 270 or even 300 probably, with finding up the decent critical damage in here. So far, I only have like 3 parts with critical damage. So let's say if I can get like 16% or probably 20% critical damage on each part. If I can get that on the other 3 parts, it could be 286% critical damage, which is already awesome in my opinion. Yep. So this is Madoka. I really try hard to raise her for this video. Yep, level 60 max. No rank up because I need duplicate for this, right? So I cannot rank up her without spending more, basically. So for FTP, rank 1 is already good enough. And yeah, don't forget you can change the skin. This is the original one, right? And this is the cooler version of her, basically. Yeah, so that is Madoka Kaname. In my opinion, she is very strong. A very strong Nuker unit. No wonder she got SS tier on the Japan version. She has attack plus 50% buff, which she can initiate by herself. And then high damage skill 3 with defense penetration, which is, you know, it can go to up to 85% if I max out the weapon. As you can see here, Incarnation of Mercy, improve the effect of piercing 85%, wow. And the passive skill, before taking the first turn, reduce damage received by 30% if you upgrade the weapon into level 20. Yep, so I'm still on my way to do that. But as you can see here, in this video, she is already very, very strong. So if you are asking, should I raise her? Definitely, she is good, very, very good. If you are asking, I don't have her, should I spend all of my crystals to get her? Definitely, yes, a big yes from me. She is worth the gems, the crystals, I mean. Yeah. So that's all. That is Madoka Kaname. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe now if you haven't, and see you guys next time. Bye bye. Ushippan.